And Madden 18, there are five specific types of plays that you need to be successful on the offensive side of the ball. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at those five plays specifically and breaking down each step for you so that you can really put together a good offensive game. What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and I want to welcome you to my YouTube channel. If it's your first time watching any of my content, I just want to say thank you for taking the time to watch today's video and ask you to just do me a quick favor and watch the video all the way through. All right, guys, so we're talking about the top five plays that you need to be successful. And the basic layout of that is the first thing that you need is a base play. Now, this is something that can basically establish whatever it is that you do best. So for me, I use PA post, and I kind of run basically a levels concept out of it. And that's my base play. That's what I really want to run pretty much as much as I can. If I can run that play over and over and over again, I will. And that's kind of my base play. It's something that you can use. It's basically your starting play. Now, I also talk about this being how I play. First quarter, there's different types of wording, but basically the core concept is to have, if you could only call one play for the entire game, what would that be? And that's likely going to be your base play. So every good man player has a base play. The next thing that you need is a man beater. Especially with the way that man is starting to gain some traction, I think, in the community. Being able to beat man coverage is more critical than it has been in the past, at least this season. So being able to have some type of specific play, it never fails. You're going to face someone that has a big-time man-to-man defense. It's pressure man. It's normally cover zero blitzes. And so I use PA post. I have a specific setup in PA post designed to beat him. So that's how I do it. Now, again, but it's a specific play in your playbook. It's a specific thing that you do that you're going to use to beat PA post. That's how you're going to. The third type of play that you need is a zone beater. Something that you have in your playbook that's specifically designed if they're running a lot of zone defense, like a lot of cover two or a lot of cover three or a lot of whatever it may be. You have to have a specific play in your playbook designed to beat zone. And for me, that's the Z-spot. I have a specific setup out of Z-spot that helps me beat cover three, cover four, and cover two all at the same time. So it's a specific play that you use. Brady gonna throw. It's going to help you. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. So that's the first probably three, four types of plays. And then the fourth type of play that you need is something that you're going to be able to do to use it, and you're going to be able to beat the blitz. And this type of play is, for me, it's vertical, because that play can be every blitz that they're going to throw at me. But I use the vertical play. And again, you can find all the setups for these plays in the premium membership. If you don't know what the premium membership is, it's basically my entire content library for Madden 18. That's all my guides. By purchasing the premium membership, you get access to every ebook. You get access to every
second down following the run
update video that I've done. You get access to everything that I've done that helps you. You get a whole 3-5 defense. You get the offense that we're running. Everything that I'm doing, you get access to
it.
So you can check it out. But a blitz beater is basically something that you can have, something that you can call that is designed to have some type of quick pass element to it. So for me, some people like this pretty close. They'll use top back field on that, or they'll use trying to just think on the head, some of those popular.
Which helps keep the running back clean.
A lot of people use
that trend here this afternoon.
The spacing play from Bunch, that's actually not too bad to beat it. So there's all kinds of different things you can do. The point being is you're just going to have some kind of focus, some kind of focus play that you've dedicated to beating the blitz. So, and that would, what that does is then it would use specific routes. So for example, if you're having a blitz beater, you would want to use a play that probably has some type of quick passing route. One of the most popular ones is a play called Shake. It's from the single back tight. I think you can find that in the Minnesota Vikings
playbook. Because on that particular play, they had no answer.
There's certainly things that you can do with that. The fifth play that you want to use, the fifth type of play that you want to use, is one of my favorite plays to talk about, and that's an X-factor play. And what an X-factor play is it's, in my opinion, it's a counter to the base play. It's something that you have in your playbook.
Gano out to kick this one away.
Specific play. For me, it's Z-spot. But it's something that you have in your playbook that you have specifically designed it to be what I call an X-factor. And really what I would suggest to be is a true counter to your base play. You can call this probably once or twice every drive.
It's amazing what one decision can do.
It will really throw your opponent off if it's a good counter. It's really true. It's exactly like your base play, and you go in the exact opposite direction. So, again, this used to be called the 5 sets for success. We would have a specific kind of system designed around it. But with the way the game's changed and with the way my play calling philosophy has changed and going to more of a simple model, I believe that you really just need 5 plays. You don't need 5 sets. And again, I originally started learning this from them, but their YouTube channel is just Z-Farrow's, and they do a bunch of good tips, a bunch of good videos. So anyways, just something that I wanted to put together for you guys to help you get better in this game. If you have questions about the 5 sets or the 5 plays, please let me know. I would love to talk to you about it. But the core concept, to just reiterate it one more time, is you want to have a base play. You want to have something, whatever it is, that you can just come out and you can establish it. It's just it's a base play. Just something really, really stupid, simple that you can use. I really like to play PAPs. I can hit that slant route all game long. So you want to have something like that. You then want to have something that can beat zone defense. Something that's very specific that can beat zone.
Back at the 47-yard line.
But something that you have in your playbook in your arsenal that can beat zone coverage. The third thing you want to have is something specific in your arsenal that can beat man. Okay? And then once you do those couple things, then you want to shift your focus into how can I beat the blitz. Okay, so those are the 4 defenses that you're going to face, or the 3 specific defenses you're going to face. You're going to face man, you're going to face zone, or you're going to face a blitz. Pretty broken down. And then you want to use your base play and your X factor play as your core concepts that really work together. And that's the counter play that I talk about all the time on my channel is, you know, how do you have a play set up that's really going to counter what you're doing from your other plays. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching today's video. And if you're interested in the premium membership, I want to encourage you to make the investment. It's really, really good. It's really, really powerful. It literally gives you a whole year of content. I think we have 8 update videos in the premium membership right now. We have 2 ebooks on the way. They already have 2, and they actually have 2 more coming after those launch. So for a total of 6.